Oh, hi there.
Hello, hello. I know you've been waiting for quite some time. And that some time apparently became way longer than I initially anticipated. But hopefully you can forgive me.
Fuck you.
Now, right out of the gate, I'm jumping on topic that received a lot of heat during my, let's say, vacation. The Witcher. And especially the TV show after Henry Cavill's resignation. To speak the topic, you know, I'm here mostly to give my opinion, but I'm still gonna start with a little bit of perspective on the whole creation of different Witcher stories and the universe itself, right? As you know, the original story came from Andrzej Sapkowski back in early 90s. The story began with three short tales: Witcher, Sword of Destiny, and The Last Wish. And then it continued with six main novels that were written throughout the 90s, and basically that is it. The books were only locally known, and the small indie company CD Projekt Red were working on the first game of Witcher series. And by the way, rights to a whole story, the whole Witcher story, were bought by CD Projekt Red from Andrzej for $9,500. Which may sound ridiculous, and it is ridiculous even by 2005 standards, but the Andrzej said himself that he wasn't actually interested in the whole game related stuff, and it's understandable. This is a small game from Polish company, the books aren't as popular and not even globally translated yet. So yeah, makes sense. But little did he know that this game got 8 out of 10 reviews on release, basically everywhere, and was striking players with the interaction part of the game when you actually was needed to make some game-changing decisions and not just rampage through the enemies to the victory. And bear in mind, for 2005, this was beyond impressive. So the books naturally got some attention too. They were translated to English and became available worldwide. And that's how a passionate game created one of the world's most popular fantasy worlds. Or even the universe, right? And the years after that, the TV show and animated shows were created. And by the way, I still don't fucking understand what was the purpose of Witcher's anime, except of, you know, money making. Don't get me wrong, it's well made shows, it's properly made anime, but looks so out of line, out of character, out of style for the whole universe of Witcher. So even being a fan, that's quite hard to justify. With that being said about the game, from now on I don't wanna hear shit like game story differs from the books, so it's bad. No. First of all, it has a right to be different, since it's the main reason why the Witcher universe blew up in the first place. Secondly, being based on something but doing a better job at it worth something, right? So we don't say that Ford Model T is the best car in the world. Why not, if every car with four wheels and engine inside of it is based on it? You can see how on a grand scale it makes absolutely zero sense. And that is where my point comes to: games can differ from the original story, if they do it properly. And that is where we come to the hot topic of Witcher TV series. And you know, I'm not gonna talk a lot about it, I'm just gonna say some facts. Fact number one: Henry Cavill is a huge nerd and absolutely adores Witcher universe. Fact number two: his contract stated 7 whole seasons of the show if only the writers will be careful with Andrzej Sapkowski's legacy. Fact number three: not being aware of the Witcher's universe, half of the viewership of the TV show came actually only for Henry Cavill. Fact number four: Beau DeMaio, the writer for 2019 Witcher, admitted that the writing team actively dislike the work and style of Andrzej Sapkowski. You can kinda already see the small outline of a problem here, right? Fact number 5. Season 2 finale is based on the beginning of the novel Time of Contempt. But the word based here is probably the odd one, cause it has absolutely zero common ground with the book. They just went the other direction for some unknown reasons. Fact number 6. This is probably the most important one. Two major news for Henry Cavill came around last year. First, everyone is probably aware, is the return of Superman, a really high chance of small movie called Man of Steel 2. But the second reason is a little less known, the huge plans for a new Warhammer show. And we all know that his top hobby is Warhammer, but not only that, he gets to star and executive produce the whole thing. For anybody wondering, executive producer, if you try to explain it in simple words, is the big boss. He does what he feels right for the show, and he will say, hey, Henry is not a producer or a director, why is this good for him and promising for the show? Because I feel like Henry is a type of man that has brains and audacity to go and consult people who are way more professional in what he needs. And on the other hand, his producer prowess will allow him to keep the storytelling and organic feel of the show in place. To summarize all those facts, we have Mr. Cavill saying that he would love to carry on his back the whole Witcher universe show, if only you don't act big as a writer. Well, they couldn't resist the urge to pull the banana out of their pants, to show the world how stupid they are. And you can probably tell that I'm quite furious about that, right? And that is because with all their flaws, I really liked the first season, and I really felt like Henry Cavill was the centerpiece of the whole show. He paid enough homage to original voice acting and storytelling, which was really noticeable in a good way. But now, if I watch any episode and imagine Cavill not being there, this looks like any other well-funded medieval something. Absolutely average. So yeah, as a producer of the show, you have really only one job, to not upset the big boy. Well, you couldn't. So in the end, we have a basic show that will feed on its past glory and die out in a few years as a absolute nonsense filled with outrageous whims of modern writers. Shameful ending, to be honest. To conclude the video, I'm gonna say that, as you can see, there is absolutely zero secrets or any schedule problems behind the grand fall of the Witcher's TV series. This is just one bloke being fucked over by the other blokes, and it's just that simple. And despite me hating on a show a little bit, I still hope that third and last season of Henry Cavill as a Witcher will bring us great acting and action, and hopefully good news regarding Cavill's return to the show. But let's be true to ourselves, this is more than unlikely. But in the meanwhile, thank you for watching, hope you had a banger of a New Year's weekend, and see you soon!